दीपा धारणी राजीव रोहित तमित चिरंजीव ज्योति मैं ओके कैन आई स्टार्ट
यस सर
रोहित
यस सर
ओके I think I am tired from taking these two sessions. So you give me 5 minute break and you repeat this test from your side. Such that I take water. So you repeat this test from your side.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
At first,
you also speak in Hindi. You also speak in Hindi. You have no problem.
सर फ्लैकिनेस इंडेक्स कैसे मतलब 3/5 ऑफ मीन साइज होता है वो उसको भी बोलना है
एवरीथिंग व्हाट यू हैव लर्नड फ्रॉम दिस टू सेशन यू स्पीक ओके
एग्रीगेट डिटरमाइंस द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कंक्रीट इज डिटरमाइंड बाय एग्रीगेट एंड एग्रीगेट हैज अ प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ एंड वर्केबिलिटी strength is the ability to resist the gradual loading workability the ease of doing work with concrete is known as workability the shape but there are four types of shapes of aggregate rounded flaky elongated and angular we use angular rounded has more workability and angular has medium workability and more strength while rounded has less strength and flaky and elongated are not workable and not strong so we don't use them
okay good
then angular number it is measure
angularity
number it is expressed up to 0 to 11 and it is expressed in percentage of void if roundness it is used for the roundness and angularity check
okay
if angularity number is less then round aggregate if angularity number is greater than angular aggregate
okay so is any range specified for percentage volume of void you
yes,
say
sir. Okay 33 to 43%
44 okay So I think you completed. Okay. I think you completed rounded and angular aggregate part. Then you start about flaky. Okay. Good.
Then flaky. What is flaky? What is flakiness? Flakiness of a particle are those whose least lateral dimension is smaller than 0.6 or 3/5 of its mean size.
Okay. So suppose you have an aggregate whose width is something and length is something and thickness is something. So you choose the dimension which is least and you find out the mean of all the dimension. That means for width, for length, and for thickness, you find out the mean dimension. You see if your least dimension is less than your mean dimension, then that particle or that aggregate is flaky. That aggregate is flaky. Okay, good. Next,
then sir, we come to test. First of all, aggregate is taken. Aggregate is taken and it is weighted. Then we arrange
we do not,
the sieve.
Please listen. We do not weight the aggregate. We do not take the amount of aggregate as 2 kg, 2.5 kg, 3 kg, 3.5 kg, 4 kg. We do not weight them. First we take the aggregate and just put on our sieve. And then start shaking. If we find the number of aggregate is 200 from 60, which is passing from 63 mm, and it is on 50 mm, then it's okay. Because if on first sieve, on first fraction, or on first slot, if more number of particle is passing, then already I know. So our particles are. If we go down or on decreasing sieves, we find 200 number of particle is automatically present. So you do not have to take 2.5 kg, 3 kg, and so on.
So, first of all, we take aggregate and then we arrange the sieve according to the size. Least is 3.6 mm and highest is 63 mm.
Good.
Then we start shaking and 200 particles for each fraction is taken.
Okay.
Then we pass. Then each fraction is passed through that
thickness gauge.
Thickness gauge.
Okay.
Then we note the number of aggregate which is passed, and the total.
Listen here.
Please
listen. On that thickness gauge, you have a particular slot opening. So for each slot opening, a slot number is given. Just like for 63 to 50 mm slots, you have a size. For 50 to 40 mm, you have a size. For 40 to 31.5, you have a opening slots. So and so on. Continue. So you must pass turn by turn that 200 number of aggregate, or you pass one by one that 200 number of aggregate from that particular fraction or from that particular slot opening. So you count how many number of aggregate is passing, you separate out that number of aggregate, you bet them and start from your side. Okay. So we separate out that number of aggregate which is passing through that particular opening. We bet them. We bet them as W2. We also find 200 number of aggregate which is passing 200 number of aggregate which is passing from sieve. Then we bet all 200 number of aggregates. We bet them as W1, or we express the bet as W1. Now we find flakiness index value FIP, which is equal to W2 by W1 into 100. Our code or IRC say the value of W1, the value of W1 must be the value of, I think the value of flakiness index value must not be greater than 50%. So is everything clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So just remember one thing. I do not tell about these things, so I forget one thing, so I repeat this thing, because this thing is also important. So you all see here carefully, this the opening of this slot. So in some examination or in some where it is written, how we find the size of this opening. So for size of this opening, they say this size must be 3 by fifth of 63 and 50 mm slots. So 63 plus 50 mean of this. So basically this is 3 by 5th, 63 plus 50 by 2. Just suppose here you have 50 plus 40, because here we get 113. So here we get value in point. So here you see, if we add 50 plus 40, we get 90 by 2, that means 45, 19 by 2. 45 into 0.6, because 45 into 3.5 is 0.6. So just 3 by 5 into 45. So basically this 5 cut 45 9 times.
Sir, Rohit waiting na hai, sir.
Okay. Just wait. Rohit is waiting. Okay. Okay. So here I started from that point. But here the size of opening is here. Someone say what is the size of opening, or in if suppose if in your examination if they ask what is the size of opening, so basically the size of opening is 3/5 of mean slot size. 3/5 of mean slot size. So slot size is 63 and 50, so add them, 63 plus 50 by 2 into 3.5. here you get 3/5 of 50 plus 40 by 2, 90. 50 plus 40, 90. 90 divided by 2, 45. We just simplify 3/5 into 45. We get 27. So the here you observe the slot size is, or the slot dimension is 27. Also here you get 65. Here you get, just wait. I take one value which is no. Here just you see 40 plus 25. So you get 65. 65 divided by 2, what you get? 65 divided by 2, what you get? I think 32.5. You get 32.5? Here you get 40 plus 25. 40 plus 25, 65 by 2. You get 32.5. 32.5. If you multiply 32.5 into 0.6, what you get? 32.5 into 0.6. What you get?
19.5.
So see here, you get 19.5. Here, if you add 63 plus 50, you get, I think you get here one. Suppose you get here one. Yes.
Sir, इसमें जो सर एक गेज दिया हुआ नीचे में 31.5 to 25, वो तो सर उसी के मिडिल में आ जाएगा सर.
हाँ आ जाएगा, लेकिन अगर साइड में दे दिया तो क्या दिक्कत है? दे तो दिया.
नहीं नहीं वो नहीं सर, मतलब उसका जो मतलब लेंथ का जो दिया हुआ है
यहाँ पे
40 to 25 के बीच में ही तो आ जाएगा सर.
तो आ जाएगा, तो ये हम बनाए थोड़ी है, ये बनाया हुआ कहीं कोई डाल दिया होगा अपना, तो यहाँ पे डाल दिया है. ठीक है, लेकिन जो अब देखोगे तो इसी टाइप का तुमको दिखेगा. आई थिंक तुम्हारे लैब में है, तुम्हारे लैब में ये है अपरेटस, ये तुम्हारे लैब में अपरेटस है, और जो ओरिजिनली तुमको दिखाए थे वैसा ही वो तुमको दिखेगा. Just wait. Your thickness gauge is, looks like this. Your thickness gauge is, looks like this. So this is your thickness gauge. So this is your thickness gauge. So here you see, this is your thickness gauge. Here your value is 63 to 50. Here this value is 50 to 37.5. Here they have written 29 to 20. So here you also observe different value or different slot opening are given. So इसीलिए जो भी तुमको अगर कहीं भी तुमको मिले तो हमको स्टैंडर्ड से चलना है. 63, 50, 40, 31.5 and so on. क्योंकि ये गूगल का पिक है तो कुछ भी हो सकता है. ओके, बाकी समझने के लिए इसको हम रेफरेंस लिए थे. ठीक है.
Yes.
तो आइडिया क्या है, कैसे करना है, वो सब क्लियर हो गया. अब नेक्स्ट आगे चलते हैं जल्दी से इलोंगेशन टेस्ट पे. चलो सो बेसिकली इलोंगेटेड एग्रीगेट्स, elongated aggregates, you all observe here. Elongated aggregates are those greater size of which is greater than 1.8 times of its mean size. So here you observe this is one of aggregate which I already take. This is 12 mm, this dimension is 12 mm, this dimension is 8 mm, this dimension each 1 mm, so this is 1 mm thickness part. I take 1 mm mean. I already find mean is equal to 6 mm because mean x bar is equal to 1 plus 12 plus 8. I think, sorry, this value is 5, this value is 5 mm. Basically 12 plus 5 plus 1, 18/3 6 mm. Mean value is 6 mm. So for elongated particle, the definition will be changed. So elongated aggregates are those aggregate whose greater size is greater than 1.8 times of its mean size. Again, I repeat, elongated aggregates are those aggregates whose greater dimension or whose greater size is greater than 1.8 times of its mean dimension or its mean size. So just you calculate here its mean size. Mean size is 1.8 of its mean size is 1.8 into 6. So if you get 1.8 into 6, here you observe the value is 10.8. Okay, you get 10.8. You all get 10.8 mm.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you all get 10.8 mm. So basically here the greatest size of this aggregate is 12 mm. So basically this 12 mm is greater than 1.8 times of its mean dimension or its mean size. So this aggregate is known as elongated aggregate. So for this aggregate is also called flaky aggregate. This aggregate is also called elongated aggregate, because I choose such aggregate which is elongated or which is flaky also, because I take dimension in such manner such that I find the value for mean size, and I also find the size according to mean size for flaky. I get both result as flaky or as elongated. So if in question you have given aggregate whose size, that means whose dimension, whose width is 5 mm, length is 12 mm, or whose thickness is 1 mm, then the aggregate is option A, flaky, option B, elongated, option C, elongated and flaky both, option D, none of these. So you find here 12 mm is greater than 10.8 mm. So our condition is satisfied, because elongated particle or elongated aggregates are those whose greater size is greater than 1.8 times of its mean size. So this condition is also valid. For flaky, our least lateral dimension, that means 1 mm is less than 1 mm is less than the flaky aggregates are those aggregates whose least size or least lateral dimension is smaller than 0.6 times of its mean size. Also, its 0.6 times of its mean size comes out to be 3.6 mm. 1 mm is less than 3.6 mm. So this condition is also valid. So the aggregate which is given here, for example, is our flaky aggregate also, is our elongated aggregate also. So is everything clear? Because in the statement, you see here, in the statement it is given, elongated aggregates are those greater size of which is greater than 1.8 times of its mean size. So we find out mean size. Also we find out 1.8 times of mean size. We see greater size of our aggregate. We find our greater size of our aggregate is greater than our mean size. So we quoted our aggregate as elongated aggregates. So it's destiny to get such type of aggregate which is elongated and flaky both. So now move towards next point. Second point is elongation of the aggregate is measured in terms of parameter elongation index. Flakiness of aggregate or flaky aggregates is measured in terms of flakiness index. So on elongation of aggregate is measured in terms of elongation index, which represent the percentage of elongated particle in the sample. In same manner, elongated particle is also measured. This test is not applicable for aggregate having size smaller than 6.3 mm. Also, the aggregate whose size is smaller than 6.3 mm, our flakiness aggregates test is also not valid. So for elongation aggregate or for elongation index testing, our aggregate whose size is less than 6.3 mm is also not valid. In order to perform this test, sufficient amount of aggregate must be taken such that 200 pieces of each fraction can be gauged. Same point. Next point, particle then passing through respective opening over the length gauge. Here length gauge, we use length gauge. On determination of flakiness index, we use thickness gauge. For elongation index, we use length gauge. And aggregates retain, that means not passing. On flakiness index testing, we take that aggregate which is passing, but on elongation index testing, we take such aggregate which is not passing, that means which is retained over the length gauge or which is retained over the opening, and bet and express in terms of percentage. That percentage will gives us what? We gives us elongation index. So basically we find our elongation index test. So this is all about elongation index. So original bet of aggregate is expressed as elongation index. So we basically find out our elongation. These are different sieves, on that sieves on same manner we take the aggregates. We also take 200 number of aggregates here, 200 number of aggregate, 200 number of aggregate. Each aggregate is passing through that particular length gauge or that particular opening. I share the picture of length gauge. Don't worry, this is your length gauge. Just wait, this is your length gauge. Is visual to everyone? Is it visual to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is your length gauge. Okay, visual to everyone. So this
yes,
is your
sir.
okay, this is your length gauge. Everyone see here, this is your length gauge. So this is my length gauge. So on this length gauge also we have a opening here. You see one stand, two stand. So from this opening we pass our aggregate. So from this opening we pass our aggregates. Also certain numbers is given along these openings. So here they give 63 to 50. Here also they give 50 to 40. Here they give 40 to 31.5. here they give 31 to 25, and so on. So basically on sieve where 200 particles are retained for different fractions, we just take that 200 number of aggregate. Here also 200 number of aggregates. Here also 200 number of aggregate. We just pass that aggregate from this opening. We take one aggregate. We try to pass that aggregate from this opening, because this opening is of 63 to 50 mm opening. So we take the aggregate from 63 to 50 mm fraction. We try to pass that aggregate from this opening. Then we take 50 to 40. Then we try to pass that 200 aggregates from this opening. We take those aggregates which is not passing from this opening. So we take those aggregates which is not passing from that opening. So we just count number of aggregate which is not passing from this opening. So we count that number of aggregate. Suppose you count that number of aggregate as 40. 40 number of aggregate which is not passing from length gauge, then you separate that 40 number of aggregate. And 160 number of aggregate is passed, you do not count them, you do not include that in your elongation index calculation. Here you came, you see 65 number of aggregate is retained, so you count 65 number of aggregate. Here you came, here you see 80 number of aggregate is retained out of 200, you also separate out that 80 number of aggregate which is retained by passing from this length gauge. So you separate all that aggregate. You then you take that aggregate, all aggregates, you bait that aggregates which is not passing from that length gauge or from the length gauge. So that weight is equal to W2, the bait which you take prior during these fractions. That means for 200 aggregate, for 200 aggregate, for 200 aggregate, you bait all the aggregates. So this bait is W1. So if you divide W1 with, sorry, W2 with W1, you get here, what? Elongation index value. Our IRC says EIV is not greater than or not more than 50% for road construction or for preparation of concrete. So I think this is all about your elongation index testing. So I think I repeat this test again, then I ask from you all. So basically elongated aggregates are, so just I, so is everything clear to all?
Sir, यहाँ पे जैसे अगर हम 100 नंबर ऑफ एग्रीगेट लेते हैं,
हम लेंगे ही नहीं, हम क्यों माने कि हम 100 नंबर ऑफ एग्रीगेट लेते हैं, हम मानेंगे ही नहीं, हमको तो 200 लेना है, तो मानेंगे क्यों, 100 एग्रीगेट लेंगे सर, 100 क्यों लेंगे, हमारे मानने से कुछ होगा, आगे बताओ, हमको तो मानना है 200 मानना ही है
सर। ठीक है सर, 200 लेते हैं। अगर मेरा 63 mm और 50 mm में 100 पार्टिकल्स मेरा रिटेन कर जा रहा है, तो ऑब्वियस है ना सर कि 40, 31.5 ये सब पे भी रिटेन करेगा, तो मेरा ये W2 वही हो जाएगा सर, जो 100 पार्टिकल्स था उसका वेट
W2 वही हो जाएगा। ओके, हाँ
ये सर वही कंफर्म हो रहे थे।
तो इसमें क्या तुमको नहीं समझ में आते, सब बच्चे का चीज है, एक ऐसा ही लाठी ले लो, अब ये तो होता ही था, अब बचपन में एक हम लोग के यहाँ जो गाय को रखने के लिए गौशाला बनता था उसमें ऐसे ऐसे, या फिर कहीं भी देखो चाय के दुकान पे, वो बेचारा ऐसा ढड़ढड़ का बना लेता है, ऐसा ढड़ढड़ का बना लेता है, और इसमें ऐसा वो बना लेता है ताकि वो उसमें से सांप तो घुस जाता है, उसके अंदर स्नैक घुस जाता है, लेकिन जो भी कैट डॉग रहते हैं वो नहीं घुस पाते हैं। तो वही तो सब खेला यहाँ पे हो रहा है, यहाँ पे बस एग्रीगेट को घुसा रहे, जो नहीं घुस पाएगा उसको बाहर रख लेंगे, उसका बेट कर लेंगे, तो यही तो हो रहा है, और जो मानने के लिए बोला है बस उसी को मानना है। अब हम नहीं मान सकते कि हम 150 लेंगे, हम 120 लेंगे, हम 100 लेंगे, लेंगे तो 200 ही लेंगे, अब लेंगे तो 63 mm के साइज को ही लेंगे, क्योंकि ये सारा का सारा चीज, ये जो पूरा का पूरा टेस्टिंग है 100-200 साल से चलते आ रहा है, ये सब पे रिसर्च होते रहा है, तब तो जाके इतना मॉडिफिकेशन होके ऐसे ऐसे मिला, और हम लोगों को करना है ऐसे ऐसे कर लेना। तो अब मानने के लिए तो बहुत कुछ मान लेते हैं, मानते तो आए हैं कि माना कि रामू का एज एक्स था, लेकिन रामू का एज एक्स थोड़ी था, निकाल के आए होगे तो बताओ कि हाँ रामू का एज 21 साल था, लेकिन मान के चले थे एक्स, या तो मानने को तो कुछ भी मान सकते हैं, तो मानना नहीं है, जो बेसिक है, जो हमारा कोड बोला है उसी के अनुसार चल रहा है। ओके,
यस सर।
ओके, नेक्स्ट आई थिंक आई रिपीट all things. So basically in today's class I discuss about flaky aggregates and elongated aggregate. First of all I differentiate between elongated aggregate and flaky aggregate. So basically flaky aggregates are those aggregates whose least lateral dimension is smaller than 0.6 times of mean size. Elongated aggregates whose greater size or greater dimension is greater. Greater dimension is greater than 1.8 times of its mean size or mean dimension. So do not get confused between elongated aggregate and between flaky aggregate, because in flaky aggregates, least lateral dimension is smaller than 0.6, and on elongated aggregates, its greater dimension is greater than 1.8 of its mean size. Because in examination, they ask this question, your elongation aggregates is 0.6 times of its mean size, your 1.2 times of your mean size, 1.8 times of your mean size, 2 times of your mean size. They want to get you confused, but you do not get confused, because I already discussed 3 to 4 times that what is flaky aggregate and what are elongated aggregates. So basically, elongated aggregates are those aggregates whose greater size is greater than 1.8 times of its mean size. Elongation of the aggregate is measured in terms of parameter, which is known as elongation index, which represent percentage of elongated particle in the sample. This test, that means elongation test, elongation index test, is not applicable or not suitable for those aggregates whose size is smaller than 6.3 mm. In order to perform this test, sufficient amount of aggregate must be taken such that 200 pieces of each fraction can be gauged, or 200 number of pieces can be selected. Particles then passing one by one or turn by turn from the length gauge, and aggregate which is not passing or which is retained over the length gauge is separated out and then bait that aggregates. The bait which is not passing from that length gauge is expressed as W2, and already we bait the aggregate of 200 number of pieces which will be retained on particular fraction of sieves. So basically that value is W1. If we divide W2 by W1, because here W2 is smaller. So here W2 is smaller. So W2 into W1, and we multiply it by 100, we get our EIV, elongation index value. Elongation index value. This value should not be more than 15%. Also for flakiness index value, this value should not be more than 50%. So our IRC say, if for both, for combined form, that means for both elongation and flakiness index value should not be greater than 30%, because 15 plus 15 is equal to 30%. So I think I discussed all the technical aspects of your elongation index test and all the technical aspect of your flakiness index test. Here you also observe here the length gauge is like this. Here is your length gauge. Just wait, one thing I forget. Clear all drawing. So just wait, here is your length gauge. So here is your length gauge. This is your stands. One stand, two stands, three stand, four stands, and so on. Here is your marking. Marking 63 to 50, 50 to 40, 40 to 30, 1.5, and so on. The opening or the slot opening is also 1.8. Here, 1.8 into 63 plus 50 by 2. Okay, here 1.8 into 50 plus 40 by 2. Here 1.8 into 40 plus 31.5 by 2. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I want Deepa.
Yes, sir.
You repeat all the test, because I think you understand all the test. So you repeat all the test in Hindi. I give you freedom. You repeat all the test in Hindi within 3 minutes. Because after 3 minutes, I end our session or today class. So you repeat. I think you understand all things. So you repeat.
सर समझ में तो आया है लेकिन एक्सप्लेन करके प्रोसीड्यूर नहीं लेकिन सर शॉर्टकट में लिखी हुई है
ओके यू स्पीक इन शॉर्टकट व्हाट यू अंडरस्टैंड प्लीज से टू मी
इलोंगेटेड एग्रीगेट आर ग्रेटर साइज व्हिच इज ग्रेटर देन 1.8 टाइम्स ऑफ इट्स मीन साइज
ओके
इलोंगेटेड ऑफ एग्रीगेट इज मेजर्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ इलोंगेशन इंडेक्स which is represented by elongated particle in the sample.
Okay.
Elongation of aggregate is not applicable for a smaller than 6.3 mm.
Hmm.
Take 200 particles which is not passing through 6.63 mm.
Okay.
take weight of this retained sample as W2
okay
and take initial weight of aggregate as W1 elongation index value is equal to W2 by W1 into 100 and elongation index value should not more than 50% of aggregate. Sir, ho gaya.
Okay. So I think everything is clear to everyone.
If anyone has any
problem, please say to me. I clear his or her doubt within 1 or 2 minutes. So, is any doubt left?
कोई aggregate flake, sir? कोई same aggregate flake की और elongated हो सकता sir?
हो गया. अभी तो हो गया.
हाँ ये वही sir. उसी लिए पूछ रहे sir.
हो गया. Test करके तो बता दिया तुमको.
Yes.
तुम भी एक अब क्या करना कि कहीं अगर काम हो रहा होगा कंस्ट्रक्शन साइट पे एक एग्रीगेट उठाना और सारा का सारा टेस्ट करके देखना हो सकता है तुम बता देना कि हाँ भाई ये फ्लैकी है ये तुम्हारा इलोंगेटेड भी है अभी तो करा दिए एक एग्रीगेट को हम
यस सर
तो फिर अब उसी में हम 12 के जगह 8 ले लेते एक जगह लिए एक एक जगह लिए तुम्हारा 5 एक जगह 8 ले लेते तो वो तुम्हारा इलोंगेटेड नहीं रहता क्योंकि 10 पॉइंट आई थिंक कितना आया था 1.8 इंटू 16.8 10.8 से छोटा हो गया ना 8 तो वो इलोंगेटेड नहीं रहा तो बस फ्लैकी हो गया ओके
यस
ओके तो सब कुछ क्लियर है
यस सर
ओके 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 आई थिंक टुमारो
थैंक यू सर
ओके थैंक यू आई थिंक टुमारो इज आल्सो योर क्लास सो आई कंटिन्यू योर क्लास टुमारो एंड माय नेक्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ डिस्कशन इन योर टुमारो क्लास इज But I think side distance, stopping side distance. So you already read these things because I upload all the things in your LMS portal. So कल start करते हैं तुम्हारा next आगे जो है stopping side distance वही चल रहा है शायद अभी SST ही चल रहा है चलो ठीक है तो
कल yes sir
okay ठीक है तो okay ठीक है तो class को यहीं पे अब end कर रहे हैं okay
thank you sir
thank you
thank you sir
Thank you.